SONiC has been there for a long time. The configuration of SONiC switches so far is being largely done via CLI. A few users moved forward and implemented automation using Ansible or Nornier-like tools, and sometimes with commercial solutions. After the Monsoon, which is an open source monitoring solution for SONiC switches, today I would like to introduce Project ORCA, an open source orchestration and network management solution for the network of SONiC switches. Hello, my name is Kamal Bhatt and I am working as a software product manager at STORDIS. Let's have a look into ORCA. There are multiple modules of ORCA project. At its core is ORCA Network Library, which can be considered to be a primary interface to the network of SONiC switches. ORCA Network Library provides Python APIs to perform CRUD operations on SONiC switches. ORCA Network Library uses gnmi interface of SONiC switches for their configuration. ORCA Network Library maintains the network and device information in Neo4j graph database. Being a Python package, ORCA Network Library can be utilized in a number of ways. For example, ORCA Network Library can be used to develop a plugin in documentation tools like NetBox to show the comparison between real-time network state versus the intention or the documentation. Or user can create a Jupyter notebook for network data analytics using the APIs provided by ORCA Network Library. Also, APIs of ORCA Network Library can be integrated to your own enterprise network management solution. At the end, ORCA Network Library is like any other Python package. You can install using pip. Let's see what ORCA Network Library can do. Currently, ORCA Network Library can discover network using LLDP. During the discovery process, a number of device components, configurations, and several links are discovered, like device interfaces, BGP with remote links, MCLAC configuration with peer links, port channels, port groups, VLAN, etc. Now, let us do some practical and discover the network. For the demonstration, I have created a mesh topology in GNS3 using Broadcom's EnterpriseSONiC image. If you want to learn more on how to create a topology in GNS3, watch my video on that topic. Link is in the description. As you can see in my GNS3, I have three simulated switches connected to each other with a number of links. ORCA Network Library can start discovery by providing one or more device IPs or subnets as well in the file orca.yaml. ORCA Network Library discovers all the LLDP neighbors of the switches provided in orca.yaml automatically. So, if all of your switches in your network are connected to each other, you can provide only one of the device IPs and ORCA Network Library will discover the complete network. Although, there is one prerequisite for a topology to be discovered using LLDP. The ports connecting the devices should be enabled in advance so that the LLDP table gets populated on the devices and ORCA Network Library can read it. To see the API usage, ORCA tests are the best to refer. In the test directory of project, there are two test cases. We will be using create-config.py test suite. Test cases in this file first triggers the discovery and then do configuration of network features. Test cases does majorly four configurations. They are port channels, MCLAG, VLANs, and BGP. As you can see, for all those configurations, there are separate test cases. The configuration gets discovered and stored in Neo4j database as soon as it's created on the device. For the test cases execution, I am using testing feature of VS Code. which discovers test cases by doing a simple configuration and makes it easy to execute and debug the test cases from VS Code itself. I have selected the test class of choice in the Text Explorer, pressed the debug button so that we can see logs being printed in the debug console. Now, all the test cases in sample config discovery class starts executing. Before starting discovery, it is cleaning all the data from Neo4j. Afterwards, as you can see in the very first log, discovery is started using the IP 10.10.130.210. This is the IP which I configured in orca.yaml. Let's have a look at second line of the log. ORCA algorithm has discovered the topology along with the interface names which are connected to each other. The information is printed in the form of JSON in the logs. In the topology in GNS3, devices have multiple connections. Although for network discovery, only single connection between switches is enough. Here, additional connections are used for other configurations like BGP and MCLag. That we will see in a moment. What is being discovered can be seen in logs and Neo4j database. Neo4j database is being updated accordingly. I have opened web console of Neo4j on the right side, which you can see is being continuously updated with newly created nodes and relations between them. We will have a look into Neo4j web interface to browse topology next. As all four test cases ran successfully. Now let us see what all has been discovered and stored in Neo4j. But before proceeding, I would also like to mention a few words about Neo4j. Neo4j, as we can see, is a graph database. In simple words, it stores data in form of nodes and relations, which connects the nodes. Nodes and relations are listed on the left-hand panel. Nodes and relations in Neo4j both have their own properties. Because of those attributes, a graph database like Neo4j becomes a natural choice for representing the network. Additionally, Neo4j provides a robust web interface, which can already be used as a network topology browser. Let's first check what's in the device nodes. Just click on device node, and on the right side, you will see three switches from our GNS3 topology. But wait, we connected their several interfaces to each other. Where are those connections? Yes, technically we connected interfaces, not the devices. That's why there are no connections visible between device nodes. Instead, let us select LLDP neighbor relation from relationship type section on the left. Now we see several interface to interface LLDP neighbor relation. But which switch does those interfaces belong to? Just double click on interfaces to know that. Some additional nodes with relation to interfaces will pop up. The red colored node is port group, which the interface is a member of. Blue nodes are interfaces, and orange ones are the device nodes. As soon as you select a node or relation, you can see its property in the panel on the right. Please note that there is a pair of LLDP neighbor relation between interfaces. That's simply because the LLDP discovery algorithm found interfaces listed in the LLDP table of both the LLDP neighbor switches. But how about other connections we created between switches in our GNS3 topology? Yes, they are also discovered. Just click on remaining interfaces and GraphDB will explain the rest. Now let us have a look at VLAN discovered. Double click on the VLAN nodes to know more about the switches they belong and their member interfaces. Next, Let us see how our MCLag configuration looks. The green colored node is MCLag. By double clicking the MCLag node, several port channel nodes popped out, but they are showing protocol names as their caption. We can change the caption to lag name to make them more identifiable. Relation name connecting port channel to MCLag explain which port channel are the MCLag members to be connected to hosts, for example, and which port channels are for peer linking. By expanding peer MCLag, we can clearly see the MCLag setup we created using our test case. Similarly, next we can have a look into BGP topology created by our test case by clicking on the BGP node. Here as well, first let us change the BGP node caption to its AS number. As before, by double clicking the node, we can reveal the BGP setup we created. As you can see, remote AS and neighbors has been discovered with very fine end-to-end connection detail. The relationship names makes it very intuitive to read the BGP topology, and additional properties of nodes and relations are available in the panel on the right side. Topology can be browsed by selecting the relations from the left-hand panel as well. Thanks to Neo4j's UI that we need not to write cipher queries to filter the data from the graph. As it can be seen on the left-hand panel, there are 237 nodes and 420 relations that has been discovered by ORCA Network Library. Let us explore them. As device can be considered to be parent of all other nodes, let us select a device. As soon as we double click on a device node, numerous nodes pop up. Those nodes represent various device components and network features which we have configured on the device using our test case a few minutes ago. Let's go further and expand remaining device nodes. They look like node clusters connected to each other. In this view mode, we can see every possible connection between devices made during configuration, like LLDP, MCLag peer, BGP remote autonomous systems, BGP neighbors, etc. And within a device as well, its components like interfaces, port groups. So far we have seen that we created a simple GNS3 topology, then ORCA Network Library helped us to create configuration on the devices and also discovered and had a detailed graphical view of the configurations created. Next, I would like to briefly explain one of the test cases used to create configuration on the device. Test cases of ORCA Network Library can be used as an API reference while developing your own applications using ORCA Network Library. Let us see port channel configuration test case. It's very much like any other Python unit test case. In this test case, we are configuring port channels on all three devices of our topology we created in GNS3. Initially, as a sanity, we are first deleting the port channels by calling respective API of ORCA Network Library. As the API raises exception, in this case, we are expecting resource not found exception. Because maybe the configuration we are going to delete is not present on the device, and asserting the specific error detail to be true. Afterwards, we are adding port channels and asserting that port channels has been added. Adding channel members to it and then asserting for channel members creation as well. All APIs raises exception. But unlike channel deletion case for sanity, in this configuration, we can assume any exception to be a reason for test case failure. APIs are useful for the programmers, but for an end user, a graphical user interface is more interesting. At the end, I would like to mention the other two projects under ORCA umbrella. One is ORCA Backend, a Django-based web application backend server. And another is ORCA UI, a graphical user interface developed using React. Backend and UI can be launched by executing commands appearing on the screen. At this moment, UI supports network discovery and reading the basic information about devices, like system details, interfaces, port channels, MCLAC, BGP, port group, and VLANs. We are currently working towards putting more and more configuration options in UI itself, and provide SONiC users a complete open source orchestration solution. Hope you find this video informative. All the necessary links are in the description. Thanks for watching.